It's Marley from the Energy Boutique with your energy forecast for December 2021. So Saturday, December 4th, we have our new moon solar eclipse taking place in Sagittarius. So the peak energy will be at 2:43 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, and it's taking place at 12 degrees 22 minutes. So I really do encourage you to download your moon guide. It's 30 pages long. It will help you focus in on what it is you need to let go of and what it is you need to be manifesting as far as new intentions, patterns, and behaviors go. Really helps you sort your thoughts and feelings out. This is a big deal. We're closing out an 18-month chapter, a very serious life lesson chapter between the Gemini-Sagittarius axis. What does that mean? Well, we've had some really rocking information come in, that Gemini energy, information, details come in, how we open our minds to it, how we process that information, how we formulate new realizations and revelations within ourselves, and how we go ahead and communicate that and express that outward. And of course, that aha moment has shifted our spiritual belief system. That is that Sag energy. We want to find meaning. We want to find purpose in the pain and the suffering in which we had to just experience. This has been an ongoing 18-month cycle that now we are slamming the door on. So typically speaking, a new moon is about creating new framework, new intentions, a new emotional cycle, new wants, needs, and desires. And yes, we tend to find out what it is we want to create by sitting in the darkness. Of course, the new moon is dark in the sky. It is the dark phase of the moon. That's why things get ugly, things get heavy, things get weighted, things get crazy before a new moon, because we have to sit in the depths of the darkness with ourselves to figure out what it is we no longer want to experience so that we can create a framework on what it is we do want to experience. So this is a new moon. However, it does kind of feel like a full moon because there's a lot of releasing going on, especially releasing of pain, of suffering, of anger, of frustration. May I remind you, we just came out of Scorpio season where we had to dabble in the darkness of our shadow, where there had to be a certain death, a damage, a destruction of our ego, in our psyche, in our mental plane, and in our physical realms to free us up to find the power through the pain. That deep transformative energy carried us into Sag season, and Sagittarius season did not get off to a bang because we were smack dab in eclipse season. We had the full moon lunar eclipse in Taurus only a couple of weeks ago that activated a destruction of the systems, routines, relationships, and structures in our lives that are weak, that are not strong enough to house the new dreams, the new visions that we're actively bringing to life through our intent, through the healing journey, through our physical form and efforts. The lunar eclipse removes us of details blocking our path, while the solar eclipse that we're about to have with this new moon in Sag gifts us with something. It rewards us for our pain and suffering. It blesses us with opportunities to get ahead in life because of the 18-month struggle, the life lesson that we just fought to learn. It does take a 6-month cycle in order to see the full life of what these eclipse energies meant for us, but many of us are feeling the shift already. So let's talk about this for a second. We are on the cusp of closing this door and nailing this sucker shut, and we are on the precipice of creating a brand new path for us to follow. This is where we take the hardships, the pain, and the suffering, we pluck out the spiritual wisdom, we pluck out the silver linings, we absorb and integrate all that has transpired so that we can finally see a little bit of celebration in the tough love life lessons that we had to struggle through in order for us to be prepared, be the vibration, be the frequency that we're currently standing in order to accept the blessings that are now coming our way. This is where we renew our faith, where we renew our confidence and our optimism, where we gain a bigger, brighter vision of the plan at play and the greater dream, goal, and vision in which we are now inspired to manifest. This is when our belief system shifts. Many of us have been in a very limiting belief system due to old conditioning, likely tapped into the inner child systems and structures that we were built upon. We have to go back to our childhood and take a good look at who had a hand in molding us, because we have had those programs downloaded in our operating systems that don't necessarily align with who it is that we are and who it is that we want to be. It is time we unlearn everything that we've learned in order to learn what it is we actually need to learn to be our best, highest selves. This is where we attach to our higher selves, where we gain perspective due to the observing perspective that our higher selves allows us to do, detaching from the egoic avatar that carries the pain and the guilt and the shame and all of those negative vibration frequencies that have kept us stuck in a holding pattern, in a repetitive pattern of pain and suffering. Now we've leveled up. Now we've renovated our soul, our spirit, our emotions, our mental plane, and now we are going to get to work in Capricorn season, that is just around the corner, to start building, creating the physical reality in our physical realms and our physical lives that will start mirroring the inner transformation that we're already going through. This is where we set fire. Okay. We set the fire underneath our butts in order to use the pain and suffering that we no longer want to experience as inspiration and motivation to be better. We are pivoting. This is a pivot point. We understand that we've gotten too comfortable in the uncomfortable reality in which we've built for ourselves. And now we're willing to take a risk. We're willing to put ourselves out there, to put ourselves in foreign territory, not knowing what we're going to get, but we know it's got to be better than what it is that we've already got, because we're done with this. We are done with the pain. We are done with the trauma. We are done playing a dim light in our own lives. It's time to spark a brand new flame, to set fire in our lives so that we create, initiate, aggressively pursue a new path, a new meaning, a new purpose. This is what this new moon solar eclipse in Sag is all about. It is ruled over by Jupiter, which means that things are going to feel overwhelming. Things are going to be a little bit extra. Okay. This is a time of growth, a time of expansion. We are in a pressurized system right now, breaking us down, preparing us for a very powerful breakthrough. This is where the aha moments kick in, where we gain a whole lot of clarity to give us that oomph that we need to project ourselves in a totally different path other than the one that we've been walking. So again, I invite you to do the inner work needed to align with this energy. Download your moon guide. Listen to all of the energy forecast, the ascension symptom forecast, piece it all together. All the wisdom is already in you. You just need to expose yourself to a catalyst and a trigger in order for that knowledge to be activated and resurface within you. So I'm sending you nothing but love. I hope you have a beautiful new moon, a beautiful solar eclipse, and I'm going to see you on the other side. Bye.